Hi friends, as you all know, we will be discussing a mock exam paper before the main examination. So this time we are going to do it one more time. So I am starting with question from dividend chapter. Can a company pay dividend to shareholders out of guarantee money given by government? Is it possible to distribute the money to the shareholders? See, this question is from section 123, dividend chapter. So yes, from the 123, if you take, the company can distribute dividend from either current year's profit or previous year's accumulated profits not transferred to reserve, then surplus, that's called surplus, then free reserves, then government guarantee money. So in this question it is possible. Then, how the fraud has to be reported by the auditor in case the amount is 2 crores? This question is from section 143, subsection 12 of Companies Act 2013. So, the fraud has to be immediately reported to the Board of Directors and Audit Committee, and they have to give 45 days time. Whether they are replying or not, the auditor has to intimate to central government. The form to be used is ADT-4. Then it has to be reported within 60 days, no? So the 60 days is the outer limit. So after 45 days, you will be having 15 days. Then the next question, presiding officer of Securities Appellate Tribunal, the age limit. If he completed a term of 5 years, can he be reappointed? This question is on SEBI. So presiding officer's age limit has been amended to 70 now. So previously it was 68, now it was 70. So he has already attained. If the age limit has been done, he cannot be reappointed. For example, if the age is say 69, then he can be reappointed for a period of 1 year. If the age limit is say 68, then he can be reappointed for a period of 2 years. Then the next question, Mr. A is appointed as independent director for 3 companies. 3 years, and he was reappointed for a period of 5 years. Can he be reappointed for 2 more years? See, as per schedule 4, if you read also, section 149, subsection 4 to subsection 6 with applicability, and the following subsection if you read also, an independent director can be reappointed for one more term. That means he can be appointed for a period of 5 years, he can be reappointed for a period of another 5 years. But he cannot be reappointed more than 2 consecutive periods. So in this question, unless otherwise he takes 3 years break, cooling period, he cannot be appointed. Next question, holding and subsidiary company wants to merge. What is the section they do, they shall follow actually? So either it is section 232 or 233. So in this question, actually 232 actually to be followed, but 233 can also be followed. 233 generally followed for small companies, for fast track merger or holding company with holding one subsidiary company. In this question, it's holding company to subsidiary company, hence they have to go for 232 process only, but 233 is also available. So it's not mandatory for 233, but 232 should be followed. But they can follow 233 also, provided 90% of the shareholder agreed. Okay, then various grounds on which SFIO investigation will be ordered. See, generally SFIO investigation is by central government. So central government, if it fills, then SFIO will be appointed. SFIO will be appointed by central government under section 212 for investigation. Setting up of SFIO is 211 actually. Now, if the shareholder wants the central government's investigation, then they have to pass a special resolution. Hence, central government will do investigation. Then, Can independent director be also appointed as independent director in holding company, subsidiary company or associate company? Actually, independent director independence will not get affected if he get appointment in the holding, subsidiary, associates. Hence, he can be appointed. Then, Mr. A proposes his candidature and deposited rupees 1 lakh but failed to get appointed. But he gets 30% vote and Mr. A asks to refund the company denied. This question is from section 160 of the Companies Act 2013. Any candidature has to deposit 1 lakh rupees. If he gets more than 25%, then it shall be refunded by the board of directors. Hence, Mr. A is right in asking the refund. Company denied, the company is wrong. While counting the number of directorship under section 165, whether section 8 to be counted? Yes, obviously, no. Section 8 is excluded from the count actually. Then whether the foreign company has to be counted? Yes, it's not excluded from the count. Then, a small company held its board meeting on January 2016 and December 2016. So imagine it's incorporated in the year 2016. Then the next board meeting happened on 1/1/17. What is the due date for the fourth board meeting? So this question is actually a tricky question. It's not very easy question. On the face it may look easy. 31/12/17 may be your answer. So many people will tell that answer. No, that's wrong. Because company's board meeting is not year on year separate. It's always continuous from the previous year's last board meeting. So in this question, 31/12/16 is the board meeting date of the last year and 1/1/17 is the first board meeting of this year, because in board meeting section they use the word year and not financial year. So we can interpret as a calendar year only. So in this given question, this is small company, hence you also have an exemption that only two board meetings, means like it's not only, they can conduct just two board meetings in a year and in only each half year, but there should be at least 90 days time gap between these two board meetings. Now in this first scenario, they are having in January and December, so they have minimum time gap of 90 days and they have two board meetings each half year, yes, complied with. But in the second scenario, for example, 1/1/17 if they conducted, there is no time, minimum time gap of 90 days from 31/12/16 to 1/1/17. 1/1/17 meeting will be considered provided after 90 days. For example, January, February, March is over. So in the month of April, if they can able to conduct, April, May, June, if they conduct one more board meeting, then it will be a good board meeting. Because then only in January the conducted board meeting, you know, that would be valid, otherwise it will be invalid. So the first half year of 2017 they should have conducted on board meeting, you know, that board meeting should be at least 90 days after the last board meeting of the previous year. So 90 days after means it should be in the month of April afterwards. But you cannot conduct in the month of July because first half year you should have conducted one board meeting. So in April to June you should have conducted one board meeting. That is the next board meeting. Next, we will go to the next section. Next question. Power of board which can be made in board meeting and provision regarding the delegation of powers. Powers of board, you know, right? They can issue share capital. They can collect call money. Then they can borrow up to 100% of paid capital and free reserves. Then they can invest. Then they can do political contribution. They can do diversification of business, but subject to the approval of 180. They can give guarantee securities, etc. Okay. Which powers can be delegated? Borrowing power, investigation power, guaranteeing guarantee securities and all can be delegated to whom? Managing director, whole time director or manager, they can delegate. Or even audit committee, they can delegate. Committee, it's not audit committee, it's committee. Committee for borrowing, etc. Then, can excess spend CSR set off against the next year's spending? No. CSR spending cannot be adjusted in the next year. Company has one foreign subsidiary and one associate company. Explain the portion of consolidation. Simple section 129. So consolidation is mandatory. Subsidiary includes associate and joint venture also. Can a minority director file petition against majority director? See, directors and all cannot file petition of operation mismanagement, only shareholders can do. Next question. The minority shareholder file a petition of oppression. Now, majority shareholder filed a petition of oppression. See, it's not about minority or majority, it's about 1/10 of the shareholding. So if any person is holding 1/10 of share, then they can, that is issued share capital, then they can apply for tribunal. So 1/10 of share capital, issued share capital, or 1/10 of number of shareholders, they can do it. Next question. Surface a company took over the management. Mr. X got removed. Is he eligible for compensation? Mr. X will not be eligible for compensation because he got removed under Surface Act. So it's an exception scenario. In Surface Act, it is very clear that when the asset management company took over the company, and if the directors are removed, there won't be any compensation provided for. Then, judicial magistrate got appointed as judge of special court under the Companies Act. Whether the appointment is valid? Section 435 is very clear that only session court judge can be appointed as judge of special court. So judicial magistrate and all is not a valid judge, so the appointment is invalid. The company liquidator is a relative of one of the director. Certain creditor objected in NCLT. The creditor are right in objecting with NCLT because this person has to be removed. Conflict of interest is there. Any person who is actually unsound mind, insolvent, incapacity, and conflict of interest, these people has to be removed. Then, procedure for replacement of IRP. 75% of the creditor has to agree for it. Then they have to pass a resolution. Then they have to go to NCLT. They will be doing it. Then, key task performed by IRP. So this I will come back later. We will complete the rest of the questions. Insurance company for aircraft of Indian company got expired. Insurance of aircraft of Indian company got expired. The flight is in now Europe. Can insurance policy be taken at Europe? IRDA permission has to be taken for all the insurance companies taking insurance abroad. Generally, they cannot do it without IRDA's permission. So if anything happened without IRDA permission, it is invalid insurance. A foreign company ceased to exist in the home country. Explain the status in India. This will be striked off as unregistered company in India. When a company not entitled to make application to IBC. Okay, when a person is not entitled to make an application to IBC. Generally, a debtor who has not followed the resolution plan, or the creditor who has not followed the resolution plan, or they already in IBC, or they went for IBC in last 12 months, or they even went for liquidation now, they cannot go for IBC one more time. Then, contemporary opinion, what is the meaning? Generally, contemporary opinion means when the act was formed, how they understood it. So long ago, how they understood it. The same way you should understand now. So that is the classic example of contemporary opinion. For example, old laws like SCRA and all, it's written in 1956. So at that point of time, what technology available? So they would have made act in that point of time. So unless otherwise you understand the history, you cannot understand exactly. So contemporary opinion. So when the statute is formed, what is their intention? You should go with that intention. Effect of moratorium. See, once moratorium is ordered, the creditors cannot enforce their rights, like surface company cannot enforce their rights, and no pledge, no fresh suits can be ordered. This is effect of the moratorium. And the next question is that I told you, know that key task performed by IRP, I will tell you. So the IRP generally will conduct the creditors meeting, and he will be inviting the creditors and the board for their meeting. Then he will be taking the valuation of this assets. Then he will be giving that information memorandum to the resolution applicant, that is the corporate debtor. He will be giving the information memorandum, and he will consider the resolution plan and he will forward it to the creditor committee. So these are the duties the IRP will function. So all the best guys, do this exam very well. Okay, from this mock exam, mock test, I expect somewhere around 12 to 15 marks. So all the best. Bye bye. So if you want to send me any queries regarding this, you can send me in WhatsApp 9940512888. Thank you so much.